I'll just grab the laptop, okay?
Yeah.
Let's go in the toilet. It's up here, right?
Yeah.
Shannon, Echo Avenue, we're done. We're finished. Thanks, though.
Bye. Was that Shannon?
Yeah, yeah. Anna. Unbelievable. There we go. Okay. Last project. Gonna make it a big one.
Right.
Documentary ideas.
Oh.
What genres are they?
Nature?
Everyone loves animals.
Everyone does love animals.
Here we have two male lions in the wild.
Whoa.
What?
They're tigers. That's not.
Well, don't
work.
Move it. I've taken ages doing that.
Are we outside?
Oh.
I said you want to work.
Yeah. Okay.
Right, well that wasn't too
well,
good.
We're not going to get away with that, are we? Something historical?
No. Heavy facts. Really educate everyone.
Nice. Historical.
Hi! This field's been here since about 1438. It's been kept in very good condition. Let's take a closer look.
Why am I here? Look at me! I can't do this, mate. Not today. This just isn't right. I'm not sheep.
Right. Before you say anything, I have an idea this time. Oh, God. Oh, the pain. As you can see, I'm pretty beaten up. I've broken my leg. I've got a concussion. I was given the wrong ladder at work, and it slipped. And
wait. Cut! Johnny!
What?
What are you doing,
Johnny?
I've done
my thing.
Well, should we go again then?
Nah, just give up on this one.
Film?
Yes.
What's on?
Well, give me a chance. Cat in Paris. Midnight in Paris. Rugrats in Paris. 2 days in Paris. American Werewolf in Paris.
A lot of these are in Paris.
Oh, it's probably the place to go to, I guess.
Paris.
Salut.
Hi there. Right. It is 5 o'clock in the morning, just gone five. It's a Wednesday, a college day, but we're not going to college.
No. We are going to the most visited city in the world.
Fact.
The city of love.
Paris. Fact. Yeah, they do Paris. They do that in documentaries, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah. Right. Okay, we've got Johnny on camera.
What's up?
Basically, we're just going to give you a tour of Paris. This is pretty mental, isn't it?
Pretty much, yeah.
Enjoy the ride to Paris. It's going to be good, you know. 3 English guys, 1 black, uh-oh. Into Paris, see your love, 3 boys, that ain't gay. All right, we out.
So, we are in the BA Silver Lounge right now. Which has made me immensely happy. Free food, free wine. I'm sitting in shorts, and there is not a unsuited man here. So you can have a shower here if you want. I'm pretty sure they do weddings and other happy events. Honestly, I'm so kid here.
Come on now, are you comfortable? Right there, let the groove get in. There, right there. Are you comfortable? Right there. Let the groove get in. There, right there. Are you comfortable? Right there, let the groove get in. There, right there. Are you comfortable? Right there, let the groove get in. There, right there. Are you comfortable? Right there, let the groove get in. There, right there. Are you comfortable? Right there, let the groove get in. There, right there. Are you
Joli Francais. Did you know? Right now we're on the Paris Overground. Later we'll be on the Metro. Did you know? Paris's Metro is the second busiest in Europe. But the busiest is Moscow. I think Paris brings in about 3 million per day. But Moscow is a bit more. So if you're interested by that fact, let us know.
So it's taken us half an hour.
To go about a mile.
Well, if that. We were in the big train station, we came back out, we came back in, we found some guy who was crazy and took us somewhere wrong and...
Well, we're here now.
But we're here. We are here. Our hostel is just over there.
30 seconds.
And the Sacré-Cœur, which we'll be going to later, is just up there for a nice little alleyway.
The tourist guide.
We've just come out of the French Metro. So we're going to dump our bags and then we are off to the Eiffel Tower. Oh.
Look at that. Amazing.
Yeah. Okay, we're here.
At the Eiffel Tower.
As you probably guessed.
Obviously.
Our first destination of our tour.
Obviously, start big. We're going to give you some facts just so that we get great. The Eiffel Tower is completely made of cast iron.
And one person died while building it.
It took 2 years, 2 months, and 5 days to complete the building of the Eiffel Tower.
Sorry, John, I didn't hear that.
Hey, what? Yeah, go.
Bonjour!
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 Bonjour! Salut! Merci!
Uncovered a scam, filthy French. Ain't nobody got time for that. Look at these peasants waiting to queue. Peasants. Ain't exclusive like us.
Huh? What are you gonna say? I don't know, we're at the bottom of the Eiffel Tower, gonna get lit up.
Was that on?
There you go then.
It's magnificent. Did you know? Eiffel Tower's been using a lot of things. Films, TV, games. You think of some yourself. Team America. This poor baby gets blown up. Thankfully, he's still here today. No, y'all don't care. Y'all just looking at the view. I'm kind of jealous. I would be too. But Paris is nice, man. Look at it. The buildings are all white. I'll let it slide this time. You know, usually black are more okay.
So, we are, halfway up, a third of the way up, whatever. Amazing view right now. You can pretty much see the whole of Paris already.
Really?
So, going up to the top, and it's pretty windy and cold already, so, and I'm wearing shorts. Beautiful shorts. Bad choice.
But still,
magnificent. Absolutely stunning.
And the magnificent.
And that's where we are over there.
And we are living there.
No.
Where?
Right a bit. There. No, left a bit. There we are.
We're there. Ish.
Oh, I'm so sick. Oh, yeah.
Jonny! I'm gonna have to go through all of those now. You're never having my camera again.
Well, I'll make the most of it then, huh?
Don't do it! Why are you doing
it? I can't have it again, so you make always do it.
Go and check.
Stop!
Take some more, Jonny. There's a panoramic on there.
take photos of us taking
it. Oh, no.
In the history of the Eiffel Tower, it has actually caught fire twice. Well done. So it's caught fire twice, once in 1956 and most recently in 2003. But no one died, don't worry.
Don't worry.
It probably warmed up a bit.
It's freezing.
We'll be right back.
we've joined the 7 million other people that will view this beautiful attraction this year. This is quite a nice place.
It's great spot for any sort of pictures, including selfies.
Cute, right?
You've seen the Eiffel Tower, you've seen the landscape around it, a few nice buildings, people, mountains.
I'm wondering though how they did attach all the lights to that. It's about 5 billion lights on that.
Really?
Yeah. That's what the facts say.
Well, beautiful specs, good at night. Hard work pays off, looks good, and they make money from it, so everyone's a winner. Yeah.
Oh, the guy just jumped in water. What a fool! What a fool! If I had money, I'd slap him with it. My titty! His name is T, grew up with me, and all my other ones came on holiday before, so I was like, why don't you come? I don't care if I'm 19, I love this boy.
I was too excited.
No, no.
So pretty much we're sitting in our hostel.
We've heard the sweet sounds of MJ.
Oh, Michael! Little Michael!
Michael Jackson is here, so, in Paris.
But there's a street performer, so we're gonna go and film him. And because we've seen a few street performers actually, so it's actually quite interesting how
I'm just walking across this road without looking.
How it happens a lot more here than it does in London. So let's have a look. And he's changed his costume already. So we're a bit revamped and revitalized now. We've had a bit of a kip. It's a bit late now, so we've been up for many, many hours. But we're going to go to the Sacré-Cœur now, which is where the Basilica stands. And it's been a sacred place since about around pagan times. And it's meant to be a very beautiful place and a great place to see views and stuff like that. And luckily, our hostel is over there, and it's just up this alleyway here. So, just going to have a gander.
Yep.
As you know, we're probably not the most religious of people, but it's also known as a very beautiful kind of site, as well as a place for many religious people to go and worship, and just, you know, generally find themselves religious.
How many shops in Paris are called that?
Oh, look at that.
Get that. I've got it.
Right, I see this is a good opportunity to use some interview techniques we've been learning about. I'm gonna check this tourist out over here, come with me. Excuse me, you
right? Hey.
Yeah, great. What brings you here to Sacré-Cœur?
Well, my mother, she used to take me here when I was small, baby. She loved it here.
She loved it here?
Yeah, she loved it here. She's a Catholic, so we used to come here and we do pray and we look at all the old things. And
look
stuff.
At the old things?
Oh, yeah, we used to go in and she'd tell me about all the pagans and the Romans and all the statues and things like that.
All the statues?
Oh, yes, there's lots of statues in here, so there's one to the Mercury, which is the Roman god, and one to Mars, which is another Roman god.
So, another Roman god?
Oh, she loves the Roman god. She used to tell me all the time about them, so it's just something that I've grown up with. So.
You've grown up with it?
Oh, yes. Well, like I say, we've been coming here since I was very small, and it's just something dear to me, seeing, you know, in my heart.
In your heart?
Oh, yes, because my mother is not around anymore, so I like to come.
Not around anymore?
No, she passed away, like a granddad. He was quite crazy and he made rocket to go into space, but he did not work.
It didn't work?
No, he made it out of carrots, so nobody knew why. He loved rabbits, so...
Rabbits? You love rabbits?
Oh, yes, he had like 20 rabbits all the time. They'd be jumping around and things like that.
I think we've got enough here.
Okay.
Enjoy the rest of your evening.
Thank you very much.
Is that good enough? I think that'd be fine. Okay. Don't you think this and the Taj Mahal might have some copyright issues?
Probably, yeah.
Which came first?
The whole dome thing.
The whole dome thing. Very original, is it?
The crosses at the top, I think, kind of kill it.
that kind of stands out, yeah. Right, let's take a closer look.
Let's come on. All these stairs. It's like Hogwarts. Too many stairs. First thing.
So the great thing about the Sacré-Cœur is that it's not only used for religious escapades of sorts, also obviously many people come here just because it's such a nice landmark, and also apparently in the night a lot of Parisians come here because the nightlife is just amazing. You've got an amazing view and they just have a few drinks, chill out and go home. Also, you can work out. It's his own Sacré-Cœur gym. Pumping mad white stone, son.
So I'm in the entrance of the Sacré-Cœur, obviously a very beautiful site, and we can see that the walls are all made up of white stone. What it has is it's got a high concentration of calcite, which means that in the damp weather and the harsh weathers, the calcite actually seeps out and makes the stone look, well, really white, and which means it's been preserved for centuries as well.
And the like, and this just proves everything really. It's just the flair that you see around Paris at night time and in the day as well, but nothing is half-heartedly done. Everything seems to be perfect. So there's dancers, there's bands, there's the lot, and it's just on the streets, so.
Restaurant. It looks like some famous faces have eaten here. You've got Aretha Franklin, you've got Elvis, you've got Ray Charles. They said to try the fries, or as they call it here, frites.
Give it a try. What does it taste like?
Decent. Decent. Even the size of it.
Where have we come, Johnny?
McDonald's. Le manger.
Go on, take a big old bite.
Oh, no.
He's got two.
Yeah. Johnny went for two.
Grand boisson.
You take a massive bite of your burger.
Ah, oui, monsieur.
Like a champ.
But these.
What did Rhys get?
These are French fries, aren't they? So I can get away with eating these, yeah?
I don't know.
It's a French documentary, French fries.
Yeah, well.
That works.
Le make chicken sandwich.
McDo. What did you expect, huh? Everyone loves McDonald's. Everyone.
Real taste of France right there. French fries, French burger, French bacon.
Bien!
Okay, good morning. Well, actually, good afternoon. We all overslept. Today we're taking you to a place you probably haven't been to before. Where is it, Jowad?
Grevin.
I tried to explain myself to someone, telling them that we were going to Grevin, which obviously didn't work too well because he didn't understand for about 5 minutes until we said Grevin.
Hello, so we are at Grevin. We've got our pamphlets and we have entered. And pretty much what Grevin is it's a... What are you doing?
It's Grevin.
That's not...
Okay,
we'll do it
again. In short, it's basically Madame Tussauds, but not as good.
Wait, what did you just say? It's a waxwork museum, but apparently some of the waxworks aren't that good. So hopefully we're going to find some doozies. Just go and have a look up the Stairway to Heaven. friend, Mr. French Waxman. Now the problem is that there's a lot of French people that we don't know.
Yeah, and also there's a lot of wax French people that we don't know.
Exactly, exactly.
But we're doing this for you, so you don't have to.
For you.
Sorry, sorry.
You shouldn't have done that.
Told off for touching the guy's hair.
They say not to touch. So this is Jackie Chan, but he looks rather old and a little bit sick, I would say.
Dude,
compared to the real Jackie. Just saying.
I don't know who this is. It looks like she could properly play a part in EastEnders. But I do know that that guy's checking her out. That guy.
That's Bruce Willis.
What?
This guy, he's saying, right, what is your name, what is your problem?
You feeling big now, son? Dali, finally, my favourite so far, Salvador Dali. I think what this proves, really, is that the French are a bit more cultural than we are, because our Man and Two Swords is just famous people, and theirs is actually people who have done things in the world, so...
Came from that. To me, only Italian.
You ain't doing too bad, huh?
Right, sorry, but this is the poorest thing so far. Follow me. It's not even made of wax.
It is Goshen's for you.
Sorry, can we just check out the shoddy workmanship and check out the badge, please? Look at that. I've seen school plays with their costumes.
That's pretty creepy.
So we've come to a nice quiet little cafe off of one of the roads we are, just after Grevin, and we've ordered some escargot, which is snails, and they weren't very happy that we just ordered snails, but I'm sure it'll be fine, I'm sure they'll live. And yeah, so we'll see what happens when we eat snails.
Okay, so what? I don't know what to do.
Just pick it up. Well, not like that. Definitely not like that. How are you going to get into it? Like that. And then get into it. There you go. Bon appetit.
We're very French, we can definitely, we know how to.
This is so funny.
We know how to get into these.
Oh my god.
I can't even open it. Jeez.
You can see how much I'm shaking.
Okay. We should, you know, I don't know what this is going to be like.
Just eat it, because you wouldn't be fine. No, he doesn't like it.
They're weird. They're very weird.
I think it's going to be worse for us, actually, having to do them after him. I find this really offensive.
Oh.
No? Oh, yeah. I can smell it quite calm.
I'm still chewing, by the way. Very chewy.
Actually. Bigger than your kind of garden snail, aren't they?
How was it?
I don't want to hear it.
Okay, he doesn't want to hear it. Over to Jowad. Look how big it is. No, no.
That's cheating.
No way.
That's got it, Brit.
No,
that's not cheating.
Don't.
That's not cheating.
No.
Look at it, man. Not too bad.
The garlic makes it better than it looks. It smells a little bit. It's just you'll keep chewing. Oh, it's down. Johnny, it's over to you.
Kinda hot.
Just don't think about slavery snails and garlics and the way they fizz and salt.
Done. Because these ones are probably farmed and they're made to be eaten. When you think about it, I was thinking about the ones I see on the floor when it's wet. It's fat.
Which one should I go for? This is the hardest bit, picking it up.
Look at him. That's gonna be.
Oh. It doesn't look appetizing, does
it's
it?
It's gonna come back to life in your stomach. Wriggle its way out.
True, actually.
Get it down here.
That time I was actually.
Go on. Oh, slimy style.
That's made it worse.
The French made it worse.
I think it's made it worse. But
so it's mixing, probably.
Have some wine to wash it down. Be proper French.
Wine?
Yeah, wash it down with some wine.
Go full on French.
Yeah.
And then the camera froze, and I panicked that we lost all the footage. So we rushed back to the hostel to try to get it all off, when the fire alarm went off.
Who's got a fire?
Did you go downstairs?
I looked my head, and no one was here, but just hold the door.
You're thinking of taking things if there is a fire?
Yeah.
Well, passports in the Mac
what,
bag.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Nah, people are going now.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. Where's my camera? That's all right then, don't worry.
Good thing we stopped to get the good stuff there. Come on, goes back up.
There's no fire, guys. It's just a joke.
Oh, great. Sun's moving anyway.
It's all banter.
So, the fire alarm just went off in our hostel, so obviously we grabbed this camera, that camera, my Mac, which is...
And the passports.
And all passports. So, if they ever tell you don't stop to take your belongings when there's a fire, just do it anyway.
So we thought we might do a bit of a shopping while we're here. So we stumbled across this department
amazing,
store.
Amazing department store. It's called Lafayette. And yeah, just have a look.
Might want to add that we can't actually afford anything here. So we'll just have a look for Gucci's and Paco Rabanne's and expensive things that I don't even understand most of it. So.
But we'll walk out smelling better.
So. Exactly, yeah, it smells delightful. But seriously, it's phenomenal. The detail and the whole structure is just... It's ridiculous. It's such a department store.
Found it really. Hey.
So we're off in search of some food, maybe something not so snaily and slimy, and we came across this lovely museum, the Museum of Pompadoms or
Pompidou, Jowad.
Pompidou, yeah, and it's look, all the pipes are on the outside.
Lovely, and it houses the largest museum of modern art in Europe.
That must have taken so long to do, that graffiti. Well, you said it's graffiti. Or is it art?
All
Okay, we found this quirky restaurant here, just off side street, this district of Paris. And it's in complete darkness. You can't see what you're eating. It's actually
very sensual.
Oh, yeah.
But it's waited on by blind people, which is quite cool, quite quirky, quite nice. I enjoy the idea. So what happens is pretty much you eat in the dark, which means that apparently your senses are heightened because it's 100% pitch black. So there is no other senses going.
And it makes great TV.
So, in we go.
Rhys, where have you gone?
I don't know.
Rhys!
I can't see much.
Bloody hell!
Oh, right, Rhys. Oh, you're in front of me. Hi.
Hi.
So do you know how long service takes in here, or...?
I don't know. They probably don't know we're in here.
Yeah, that's true.
Oh.
What? What's this? I've got to eat meatballs with my hands.
Is it meatballs, though?
Well, I hope so. It's got a... Oh. Is that a meat... Is that a meatball? What type of meat is that?
I don't really want to eat anything now.
What meat is... Oh, there's a hair in my food. Ah! What? How am I meant to avoid the hairs if I can't see it?
This has been...
Quite scared now.
This has been a success.
This would be a great place to murder someone.
Well, it was delicious. Tasty stuff right there. What did you have, Rhys? Because I didn't see.
I think I had your finger.
Oh, yeah, I felt that for a bit. Oh, we forgot. We couldn't see Jonny, so we just carried on. Oh. We just assumed he was there, but he probably wasn't. So, pretty much, we've just come on to Blanche.
Whee!
In the metro, and we're going to the Moulin Rouge. Sexy bitches and whatnot, you know. So we're outside the Moulin Rouge, which is a very saucy place to go, really. It's Jonny. Don't do this. It makes us look really
saucy. The Moulin Rouge, baby! The Moulin Rouge in Paris! You know, we are tourists! We are from Londres!
So we're outside the Moulin Rouge, which is translated as the Red Windmill, as you can see it rolling around in the background, which I'm pretty sure is like a burlesque kind of place, but also the main pinnacle part of that film that Baz Luhrmann made.
Australia?
Australia? The Great Gap? No.
Romeo and Juliet?
Oh, yeah. The Moulin Rouge. So, you know, Beyonce, Christina Aguilera, they're all chilling out in there, singing that "Do You Want to Come to Bed with Me" song and things like that. Fact.
No!
Wasn't Beyonce. It was Lil Kim, Christina Aguilera, Pink, and
Beyonce.
No!
Yes, it was. 100%
wasn't. 100% it wasn't, so someone's wrong.
It was Beyonce.
He's wrong. It wasn't him. It was...
Okay, you tell us. Was Lil it Beyonce
Kim?
Or not? Because I'm pretty sure it was Beyonce.
It wasn't. It was...
I'm pretty sure. So we'll find out. We'll find out when we make this.
No, I already know it's not Beyonce.
Stop arguing.
I'm
because
not.
It was probably Beyonce.
You're arguing, you're right.
Right. Get out of the way.
So... Her name was...
It was Beyonce.
It was not Beyonce.
Hey, Blake,
you're going to fight him, Harry?
It was Beyonce.
Blood, it wasn't
cut
Beyonce.
Stop rolling. Stop filming. This is my video diary.
Jonny Morris here, signing in, signing out. Paris has been crazy, crazy, crazy.
We had an interesting lunch today. Snails, lovely. The camera then died.
You're not going to be green. No, come on, Jonny, don't.
We also washed it down with wine. Well, I had a sip, and then we were like, does anyone else like wine? No. So we gave it to Jonny, and then he downed it all.
I saw a couple places, had a crepe with banana and Nutella and coconut, so typical black crepe. If you know coconuts, bananas, black boy.
Actually, I should show you in our little room here. Ensuite.
Is how big would you say this is?
Not big enough to
in. I can hear someone having a shower. Could be a girl. Could be a boy.
Shout out to Rhys. Shout out to Jowad. Shout out to Keith.
I'm just glad I'm not in college, to be honest.
So,
morning.
Well, that's illegal. we've woken up, we've checked out, but we're still in the hostel because our flight has been delayed by two hours?
Yeah.
Two hours-ish. So we're just having a nice game of chess with Jonny. Me versus Jonny.
Whites v Browns.
I win!
Jonny?
It's the rain.
It's the rain. It's raining here in Paris. It's our last day. We're all packed up now. Just left the hostel. One last stop on our tour of Paris. You ready?
Yeah.
Goodbye, La Régente.
So we just spent an hour on the metro just to come to our last stop before we go home. Sad times.
Yeah. Our last stop is the home of the French champions.
PSG.
Don't worry, guys. I'm going too.
First of all, the capacity is 48,000 spectators. You know, the name Le Parc de France means the Garden of Princes. So why is it called this way? A couple of centuries ago, in the 19th century, there used to be in this area a wood where princes used to go to chase animals. So they used to call the place Le Parc de France, the Garden of Princes, and we kept the name for the stadium. As we know it today, the stadium was finished in 1972. And it has been PSG home since 74, when the team arrived to first division. About the stands, the one in front of you is called Paris. On my right, you have Boulogne. It has the name of the neighborhood behind. On my left, Auteuil has also the name of the neighborhood behind. Then, well, we'll see how does it look.
Is it owned by the club, the stadium, or is it a public?
Well, the stadium belongs to the city.
He just did our job there.
Yeah, I know. So we're pretty solid.
We'll use that.
Cheers.
You're a bit dark.
In the picture.
To give the fans a victory is always, you know, magnifique. C'est très bien.
Have you heard anything about the new signings? The double signing of Moussaif and Morgan?
Well, I watched them.
That's us.
I heard Morgan is very quick white player. So, you know, a bit of pressure for Lucas. And Moussaif, you know, he's a great keeper. Great deputy to, you know, Sirigu. And if he's good enough, he can push him for number one, but, you know...
I heard that he's coming in as number one, but...
You heard wrong.
Come on! I'm sorry!
I can't believe we just did that.
Jonny? You needed to go out of it. You're
probably the only person.
Jonny?
What, you actually put on?
No.
Oh,
So, that was Parc du Prince? Parc du
Prince? That sounds good.
Yeah, PSG. It was PSG. And it was wicked. It was very cool.
But it's all coming to an end now.
I know, it's time to leave.
We're about to go to Airporto. And is that French? That's probably Spanish.
We've
lost Jonny.
Another thing is, there's no Jonny here, so
we lost him in the shop.
Yeah, and we don't know where he's gone. So hopefully,
Jonny,
he'll be. Oh, Jonny!
PSG, baby, buddy.
My team.
Before we even left, we heard that a plane had to crash land, or like some sort of extreme situation happened where they've had to close down the runways at Heathrow, which means that instead of flying tonight at 9, we're being put up by BA, free food, free beds, and we're flying tomorrow instead. So
it's another day in Paris.
Another day.
So we've got here, and it's actually very nice. I was expecting, like, you know, a bit of a dodgy place, maybe like a man with a room and a crowbar to keep the animals away.
Crows out.
That's what you were thinking, wasn't it? Yeah.
This has genuinely cheered me up a bit. Have a gander. Have a look, mate. Nice little telly. Look at the pitch! All free of charge. Complimentary.
Free of charge.
I've got a pool in there.
Oh my god!
These are as nice as mine.
What's up,
what's up? Got a nicer view. He's got a nicer setup. Look at this mirror! Did I have a mirror?
Yes!
No, I didn't! Not like this! It wasn't this good!
What up, y'all?
This is Jowad, Jonny, and Rhys. We in the house. Flight was cancelled. What they do? They gave us a free hotel. Who's complaining? No one.
We're in a nice hotel now.
Yes.
See me?
We have single rooms with double beds each.
I still come out at the end though.
Which is pretty sick. Better than a hostel. So
yeah, so thanks BA. In the end, all comes good.
Apparently we'll get our money back as well.
What?
The little Asian dude was telling me, like, if you get delayed by like 2 hours, you get compensation.
Sick. But we're all tired. It's been a long day.
Very tired.
No, Jonny isn't tired. He's ready for some.
I'm going to party, dude.
Okay, well, Jared wants to go to bed, so yeah. We'll sign off for today, and then we'll have another day. We'll have a morning in Paris. We'll get some free breakfast, which we never got at the hostel.
No.
We turned away from the free, like, French bread.
It's too far away.
Paris.
Downstairs, so...
Eclo. So, yeah. Une blanche, un noir, au revoir.
What?
Ah, yeah.
Wait.
It's leaning.
Just say we've got the call.
Free food.
So here we are.
We've just got the call. We're leaving Paris.
Ready to board, and we just wanted to thank you for experiencing what we've experienced together. And
I hope we've given you a different side of Paris, our honest views, and great facts. Because it was meant to be a documentary.
Yeah, meant to be. Bye.